Morning. It's Saturday. Saturday morning, and got some precious cargo in the back seat. The wife and baby girl. And we're taking Christina to the hospital again this week for the fourth time.
Wow. Yeah, I have to get fluids. And I woke up this morning feeling really bad, nauseous, dehydrated. So I have to go get fluids. Part of the reason I'm feeling so bad is because I'm trying to get off the steroid. So the steroid is actually anti-nausea, anti-inflammatory. Helps you get through the chemo better. But the side effects are not working for me anymore. So, yep. My husband is going to go drop off my mom's birthday present. She's got a cold. She was going to watch Ava, but she's sick. So, that's it.
So, poor Chris has to sit in the chair alone. I don't get to stay with her. Although, Ava and I will come back and hang out for a little bit until she's done. Okay.
Hi guys, so I have a fever. Oh, this feels so good. The sun, I have the chills. I have a fever and the chills. The chemo ward almost kept me over because the doctor, my blood counts have gone down again, but that's common since the infusion. I told the nurse to tell the doctor I did not want to go to the ER. I told him that I would keep an eye on my temperature. It's like 100.3, then it goes down to 99.8. So I still have to go home and edit the video, but I'm gonna have to rest for a while and then edit it. So looks like it's gonna be daddy time again, and lots of rest for me. Hopefully this fever thing that's giving me chills goes away soon. Okay. Ava, you were such a good girl for Daddy. Ernie took Ava to give my mom her big birthday present that I forgot. And she went with him to my mom's and then came back. It sounds like they might go to Costco. Hi, Ava. She's just been her normal, calm self. She's a pretty good girl. She likes to go out and do stuff. Of course, most people do. Well, Mommy don't have the chairs no more because it's nice and warm in the car. Hi, guys. I think it's about 4 o'clock on Saturday. So, I think I said earlier, like, I had the chills and a fever, and I still have the chills. So I finally broke down and took a steroid. This might be classified under a steroid crash or not. I don't think getting off of steroids causes chills and a fever. I mean, my white counts are so low, my white blood cells, I could really have like an infection or something, which I have to be really careful about. So I've been asleep most of the afternoon. I'm going to try to go back to sleep now. I finally broke down and took the steroid because I can't handle it. Poor Ernie has to take care of Ava by himself, but he says he doesn't mind because he's like that. So, I don't know how much footage we're going to have for tomorrow's vlog, but I know you guys understand. I hope to God I feel better tomorrow because this is pretty bad. But see, I took the steroid and the redness in my cheeks are already starting to go down. So it's really good at like controlling the allergic reaction. So I mean, I might just have to put up with the weight gain or try to figure out another way to lose weight while on steroids. I don't even care about that right now. I just want to be able to tolerate these treatments so I can be around as long as possible for my family. So if I have to take steroids to get through the treatment, then that's what I'll have to do.
Hey everyone. So Christina's fever isn't breaking, and it's now just after 5. I do believe we're most likely going to have to take her to the emergency, the ER, where they will hook her up to an IV and give her antibiotics, because it is very dangerous for her to be running a fever and have the chills. She's at a high risk for infection. So, you know, God knows what could have caused it, or what infection it might be, or how she got it, but there's no reason to take any chances. And so, I don't know. I guess Alyssa will come over here and help with Ava so I could be with her at the ER. We'll let you know what happens.
Hi, guys. Good to see you. I'm here at my mom's house because she had to go to the hospital. She has a fever, which isn't good. So we just pray that it's nothing serious. Yeah, so here with Ava girl. She's playing with her new special toys that she loves so much. Wow. You like it? So yeah, kind of a bummer. Well, kind of. It is a bummer that my mom had to go to the hospital, but I'm just happy that I was available to come over and watch Ava. So yeah, we're just gonna hang out. She'll probably go to bed soon.
You like looking at stickers?
I don't know what else to say. I just hung out with my boyfriend this morning and we went to go visit his mom, and now I'm here, so kind of a boring weekend so far, but extra day with Abigail. So careful with your balls. Hey, mommy, Siri. I hope you are okay. No, not Siri. Let's send mommy lots of love right now. Okay, we don't want mommy getting sick, or than she already is. So let's just hope that the doctors can make her all better, okay, sister? Yeah, we want mommy to feel better. Yeah, because she doesn't feel good. Oh. Should we attempt to give you a bath? Even though you probably already got one, but. Should we attempt?
Well, it just took Christina back in the ER, and I had to go put something away in the car, and I'm gonna go join her now. Let's hope everything's okay.
They can't access my port, which is stressful. They found one little vein to access, the rest of my veins are dead, so. I have a fever, they have to do all this stuff, and they're probably gonna end up sending me home telling me I'm fine. So I'm very annoyed.
Well, I think the plan was to get you some antibiotics, wasn't it?
That's what your plan was. I don't know what their plan is.
Okay.
Yep, last time we were here was about a year ago, and just over a year. It's never fun. At the ER. We're trying to avoid it, but better safe than sorry.
So my mom bought all this new bath stuff for Ava, and they haven't used them yet. So I'm gonna use them because we don't have anything to do. So I'm gonna give her a bath. Are you excited? We're gonna put all this stuff in your bath. Yeah. All right, guys, so I got everything I need for Ava's bath. Set everything up. I hope my mom and Ernie don't mind that I open this stuff, but I thought it would be fun for little Ava and me. What do you think? So I got her pajamas, her towel, and her shampoo and her oil ready. We're gonna take a bath. Okay? Yeah. Ready?
Hi guys, so I'm still in the ER. Not sure if they're gonna let me go home or not. They're testing me for all different types of infections, and I feel like I'm looking better, but maybe I'm delusional. I also took the a steroid, so it's probably kicking in, taking that redness and that inflammation away. So I'm hoping I don't have to stay the night, but if I do, I guess tomorrow's vlog is probably just going to be me talking. All right, talk to you guys soon.
So Ava just finished her big girl bath, and it was like, seriously guys, like one of my favorite moments with her, because she was just like, at first she was like a little scared, but then I think she realized like, I'm a big girl now. So she had some fun, and yeah, she's all clean. Yes. Yeah. So we're gonna play for a little bit. Maybe go on the porch once the sun starts setting. And then hopefully she'll be ready for beddy bye. But she's such a clean girl now. Seriously, like so fun giving her a bath. Like who would have thought like giving a baby a bath would be so fun? But yeah, it was really fun.
Hi guys, so I got to come home, yay. they gave me a broad spectrum antibiotic and they're taking blood cultures. So that's interesting. I'll know in like 2 to 3 days, possibly I'll know what the infection is, what the source is. But for now I'm on a broad spectrum antibiotic. And then I'll be on a more specific one if they find something more specific. I am feeling better. They gave me more fluids. And Alyssa was nice enough to come watch Ava while we went to the ER. And me and Ernie just ate a really late dinner. Now we're home. Just going to try to relax. But basically, I've been doing a lot and exposing myself to a lot of things, trying to live my life. And I used to be really strict with myself when I was on chemo in the past because I didn't want to get an infection. So, I mean, this might have been something I picked up. It could even be something as simple as bacteria in my stomach or in my mouth. Because my white blood cells are so low, not able to deal with them. Or it could be something I picked up. So I have been doing a lot more, going a lot more places. And I'm probably, well, basically the doctor said I need to avoid all that. And basically be home. To avoid exposing myself to anything. So unfortunately I'm going to have to be kind of on house arrest again. To avoid this type of thing happening, because it can be really dangerous when a chemo patient gets any type of infection when your white blood cells are as low as mine. So it's really not worth the risk. As much as I've enjoyed all the things I've been doing, I mean, heck, you know, I went swimming last week. I mean, it could be 101 things that I've exposed myself to. So, that's fine. I mean, this is just part of the whole cancer life. Yeah, whether I was terminal or not, doesn't matter. I mean, anyone on chemotherapy has to be careful. But when you're on a chemotherapy like Carbo and Gemzar that I'm on, that basically the main side effect is it makes your counts go down. I just have to be really more careful. So, because I've never, ever, ever had a fever or an infection during an infusion in the 3 years I've been treated, because I used to be so strict in everything. So I just have to go back to that again, because this trip to the ER and all the like scary things that could have happened, it's not worth it. So, all right. We will see you guys tomorrow. Bye.
Let's go play in the nurseries. Go play with the princess castle. Do you want to do that? Grumpy girl?